Hello there. In this video, we'll illustrate how to use XLOM to create an exponentially smooth forecast, complete with error analysis, and introduce you to how to determine and plot the tracking signal. This question corresponds to problem 4.37 in your text and relates to John Ho's music store in Burnaby, where we have 10 weeks of historical data for music sales. And we have three requirements for this problem. The first is to forecast the demand for each week, including week 10, using exponential smoothing with an alpha of 0.5 and an initial forecast of 20, and then to compute the MAD, or mean absolute deviation, along with computing the tracking signal. What we'll do is we'll start XLOM, go by chapter. We want exponential smoothing, provided with 10 periods of historical data by week, and we'll include the tracking signal and graph as options this time. Pull that up a little bit. We're told to use an alpha of 0.5, so that's what we'll do. And for each of the weeks, we'll input the demand as indicated. 20, 21, 28, 37, 25, 29, 36, 22, 25, and 28. And here we see the graph. It shows us the blue line is our actual demand, and the gray line is the forecasted demand for each of those periods. We'll clean our decimal places up. In both the main table and you can see the tracking signal table. So this tracking signal table takes the cumulative error, and the error is the difference between the actual and the forecast. We were instructed to use 20 unit sales as an initial forecast, and therefore the difference between actual and forecast for week one is zero, and that's why the first line is blank in the table. For week two, we have actual demand of 21, and forecast the demand of 20 for a difference of 1. And on a cumulative basis, the total difference is 1. The absolute error is just the absolute value of that. The mean absolute deviation is simply the average of all previous absolute values. And the tracking signal is the cumulative error divided by the mean absolute deviation value. If you look at week 3, you can see that the actual demand is 28 and the forecast was 20.5. So that's a difference of 7.5 units. The cumulative error is the previous period's 1 plus that 7.5 to give you a cumulative error of 8.5. On an absolute basis, absolute 1 plus 7.5 is 8.5. This time the mean absolute deviation is 0 plus 1 plus 7.5 divided by 3 periods to give us 2.83. And the tracking signal then is the 8.5 cumulative error divided by the 2.83 mean absolute deviation. Now here's something that you'll notice at the very end of the table. If you didn't want to calculate the individual tracking errors and then plot them, which we'll do in a second, you can see that on the very last row, the values in the table also correspond to some other values. So if we look here, the cumulative error, of course, is the sum of all the errors for all previous periods, whether plus or minus. The cumulative absolute error is just the sum of the absolute errors. And the mean absolute deviation is also found in the table. And therefore, we could calculate the week 10 tracking signal to simply be the cumulative error of 14.05 divided by the mean absolute deviation of 4.99. And that also equals what we have in our table. Now what we can do is we can graph the tracking signal. So we'll just select all these values and just do a really quick graph. Insert, and we want a line graph. And so it looks like the tracking signals in your textbook. We'll just smooth this line out. One of the other things that you'll notice as well is that we can see that the tracking signal ranges from 2 to 4.79 mean absolute deviations. And we're also told, if you remember from your textbook, that one mean absolute deviation is roughly equal to 0.8 standard deviations. So if we take this and multiply by 0.8, that's 1.6 and 3.83. So what this is telling us is that our errors range from plus 2 to plus 4.8 mean absolute deviations, or plus 1.6 to plus 3.83 mean absolute deviations. What we like to see, however, is a forecast model with tracking signals that range between plus or minus 3 or 4 mean absolute deviations. And if we go with 3 mean absolute deviations, this suggests that for a forecast to be in control then, that 98% of the errors should fall within plus or minus 3 mean absolute deviations, which isn't the case with our data, where you can see in week 6, the tracking signal exceeds 4 mean absolute deviations. What we have here is a model that is consistently tracking positively because all of the tracking signals are positive. And remember that positive tracking tells us that the demand is greater than the forecast. Well, that's no surprise because if we look at most of our errors, right, where we take the actual minus the forecast, the errors are mostly positive, telling us that our forecasts are below the demand. We also see that in the graph down here, where our actual demand is consistently greater than the forecast model. So when we combine the tracking signal with the error analysis, especially the mean absolute percentage, we can see there's a mean absolute percentage error of 17.54%, which isn't all that great. Combine that with the fact that we are not tracking within plus or minus 3 or 4 mean absolute deviations. This is constantly positive. Ideally, over time, we'd like to see the cumulative errors roughly around 0, indicating that our forecasts are relatively accurate because the tracking signal would hover around the baseline of 0 mean absolute deviations. So there you go. Using XLOM with an exponentially smoothed model to determine error analysis and tracking signal. I hope you found this video useful.